We're going to do problem 13. 13 says to graph each equation. For this one, we have y is equal to negative x plus 2. To graph the equation, we're going to find the x and the y intercepts. This is something that's really pretty, one of the easier ways to graph it. First thing we did is we took the original equation and we put 0 in for y. And then we solved for x. That gave us the x was equal to 2, so your x-intercept would be where, excuse me, your y-intercept, I always get those mixed up, your y-intercept would be at point 20. Excuse me, your x-intercept would be at point 20, where your x-value is 2, your y-value is 0, so it's not going up or down. Next, we're going to do the same thing to find our y-intercept. Only to get our y-intercept, we're going to put 0 in for x. With 0 in for x right here, that's going to solve to say that y is equal to 2. So your x, your y-intercept is going to be at point 02. So when you graph it, you've got point 02, you've got point 20, and then you just connect them with the line, and that's all there is to it. All right, problem number 17 says the distance d in kilometers that sound waves travel through water is given by the formula d is equal to 1.6t, where t is the time in seconds. Part A says to make a table of values for the and graph the equation. Part B says to use a graph to estimate how far sound can travel in water in 7 seconds. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to take, in Part A, make our table. So they said, well, it times 0 seconds through 5 seconds. You would not necessarily need to have 6 values there, but you probably should start with 0 and go on a few seconds on up there. And we're going to start at t, where t equals 0, and evaluate the expression, multiplying 1.6 times each number of seconds, which is where you get your d column from. Good so far on how you make the table? After you make the table, all you have to do then is take the points you found here, graph them on the line, and connect your dots. And then for part B, how long is it going to take it to, excuse me, how far will it travel in 7 seconds? Well, your 7 seconds is right here, so it's going to be at this point about there, which is going to be, I'd say, about 10.6 kilometers. Let's see what it says down here. It said about 11 kilometers. I think 10.6 is closer just because I'm a picky math teacher, but they rounded up. Other questions? For 19, it says to find the root of the equation. And I'm turning back to page 163 where we learned this topic because I wanted to remind you that there's four things that mean basically the same thing here. The x-intercept is also going to be the root of the equation. The solution, where x equals 0, is going to be the root of the equation. The 0, once again, where the equation is equal to 0, is going to be the root of the equation. So what we're actually looking for where it says find the root of the equation is find out where your y value is going to be 0, find where your x-intercept is because it intercepts the x where your y value is 0, find the solution because the solution is the x-intercept where y equals 0. They all mean the same thing. So to do that, they took their original equation, they isolated their variable for x, and they found that x was equal to 6, therefore where x, remember your ordered pair is written as x and y, so your values would be at point 60, that's your x-intercept, and your solution is going to be 6, because that's the x value where y is equal to 0. It's your x-intercept. This one tells you to solve each equation by graphing. It's not real specific on which approach it wants you to use. Ideally, you would have looked and said, well, this particular problem number 23 in section, let's see here. That would be in the review for section 2. So then you would have turned your book to section 2 to see which one of the skills they want you to know how to do. This one they wanted you to use a table for. So they said the related function is going to be y is equal to 3x plus 21, because when you can get it in the point, 0 equals 21 plus 3x, that's the same thing as 0 is equal to 3x plus 21, which is also the same thing as y is equal to 3x plus 21 is a related function. Now that you have that, you can change the y to be your f of x, because it is a function, and go through and select different values. You choose your x values to fit the equation so that you get nice y values. Think about it. If you select x values and then you get really ugly y values, you probably want to select different x values. So it's one of those things where in big boy and big girl math, we're giving you the freedom to choose the values, but if the values you pick don't come out with nice y's, you probably need to step back and say, I probably need to pick different numbers so that you can have something that's graphable. And when it's all said and done, the graph of the equation should look just like that. And as far as it says, the graph intersects the x-axis at negative 7, so the solution to the graph, where y is 0, x is negative 7, is right there. Anything we learned is fair game for the test. Tristan, for problem number 35, it starts off by saying, suppose y varies directly as x. Remember, anytime you see that, you know you're using the direct variation formula, direct variation equation, y is equal to kx. Anytime you see suppose y varies directly as x, start off by writing down y equals kx, because you're going to need that. Whoops, didn't mean to do that. All right, we're back in the game now. If, it says write a direct variation equation that relates x to y, then solve. If y is equal to 15, x is equal to 2, find y when x is equal to 8. Well, first thing we're going to do is we're going to focus on this part of it right here, where y is 15, x is 2. And in the solution, they took the direct variation formula, they put 15 in for y, and 2 in for x, and solved to find their k value, their constant of variation. Okay? Then they took the constant of variation, came down here, and plugged it in, y equals 7.5x. They took their new x value of 8, plugged it in right there, and solved for y so that you know that y is equal to 60 when x is equal to 8. All right, for problem number 43, it states, the table shows the distance traveled by sound and water. Write an equation for this sequence. There's a key word right there. It says for this sequence. You should have also noted that you have 1, 2, 3, 4. That shows you a sequence of events going on there. Then find the time for the sound to travel the 72,300 feet. When you're doing this, you had to use the formula a sub n equals a sub 1 plus the difference between n and 1 all times d, where your starting point, your a sub 1, is going to be the 4,820, and the difference between each one of these jumps here is also going to be 4,820. You plug those values in, use your distributive property, simplify, and you get your formula of a sub n is equal to 4,820 times n. That answers the first part of the problem. Write the equation for this sequence. That takes care of that part. Now you get to do the next part that says find the time for sound to travel 72,300 feet. Whoops, don't want that one. So to do that, we're going to take our equation, and the a sub n value, we're going to plug in the 72,300, isolate our variable, and find out that it's going to take 15 seconds for the sound to travel the 72,300 feet. Question on that one? What you got? Okay, you talking about right here, we're using the commutative property? Yes, they're using the commutative property and substitution. They're moving this over here, and then they're saying plus 4820 minus 4820, and those two cancel each other out. But we're starting to get away. If you've noticed, I've not been telling you to write down your steps anymore, because if you haven't figured those steps out by now, you're probably not going to. You can, at this stage, just take line, those two are canceled, leaving the 4820 in. All right, question was, if the numbers were different, say if that was 500 instead of the 4820, then what I would have done is I would use my commutative property. A sub n is equal to, I'd probably use the 4820 n, get my variable first, plus 500 minus the 4820. A sub n is going to equal to, that should be a zero there, 4820 n minus 4320. And that would be your equation for that line.
Okay, so if it would have been a negative, just carry the negative sign.